हेलो माय डियर क्यूरियस स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू लेक्चर नंबर 2 ऑन मॉस वायर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द डिफिकल्टीज अराइजिंग इन रेजोनेंस कैप्चर प्रोसेस, दैट इज रेजोनेंस एब्जॉर्प्शन अराइजिंग फ्रॉम न्यूक्लियर रिकॉइल एंड डॉपलर शिफ्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस रिकैपिचुलेट रेजोनेंस कैप्चर प्रोसेस। In the last of the previous video, we have seen resonance capture process. Now the question arises, what is resonance capture process? The emission of gamma radiation during the transition of nucleus from the excited state to the ground state and its subsequent absorption by the nearby isomeric nucleus is called resonance capture process. It has been illustrated in the following figure as discussed in the previous video. It appears that resonance capture process will take place quite easily because the energy difference between the excited state and ground state will be the same. In the case of both de-excitation and excitation. This is de-excitation process in which nucleus undergoes transition from higher energy level to lower energy level by emitting energy equal to 14.4 kilo electron volt. In the excitation process, the ground state nucleus undergoes transition to the excited state by absorbing energy equal to 14.4 kilo electron volt. Please note that the energy difference between the excited state and the ground state in both the cases is the same and it is equal to 14.4 kilo electron volt. However, the resonance capture process is not considered to be feasible, is not considered to be possible on account of following two reasons. First, nuclear recoil, and second, narrow line width of gamma emission. In this video, we will discuss nuclear recoil. When the 14.4 kilo electron volt Fe57 nucleus emits gamma ray with frequency 3.5 into 10 to the power 18 per second, the nucleus will recoil or the nucleus will move in a direction opposite to the gamma ray in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum as shown in the following figure. This is excited state nucleus of Fe57 with energy 14.4 kilo electron volt. It emits gamma radiation in this direction. Then, according to the law of conservation of momentum, the daughter nucleus or the recoil nucleus will move in a direction opposite to the direction of gamma ray. This is in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum. The nucleus moving in a direction opposite to the direction of emission of gamma ray is called recoil nucleus. The velocity with which the recoil nucleus moves is called recoil velocity. Its energy is called recoil energy, and this phenomenon is called nuclear recoil. Please repeat it again. The nucleus moving in a direction opposite to the direction of emission of gamma ray is called recoil nucleus. The velocity with which the recoil nucleus moves is called recoil velocity. Its energy is called recoil energy, and this phenomenon is called nuclear recoil. Now, self-assessment. Calculate the recoil velocity of a free MOS wire nucleus Fe57 emitting gamma ray with frequency 3.5 into 10 to the power 18 per second. Please pause the video and try to solve the problem within 5 minutes. Here is the solution of this problem. According to the law of conservation of momentum, momentum of Fe57 nucleus, that is recoil nucleus, will be equal to the momentum of gamma ray. The momentum of recoil nucleus is given by m into v, and the momentum of gamma ray, which is an electromagnetic radiation, is given by h nu by c. The mass of recoil nucleus is 57 amu, and we know that 1 amu is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. This is recoil velocity. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 arc second is the value of Planck's constant in CGS system. The frequency of gamma radiation is 3.5 into 10 to the power 18 per second. And the velocity of electromagnetic radiation, that is gamma radiation, is 3 into 10 to the power 10 centimeter per second. On solving this equation, the recoil velocity comes equal to 8.2 into 10 to the power 3 centimeter per second. This is the value of recoil velocity. It is obvious that the ground state Fe57 nucleus formed by the emission of gamma ray from 14.4 kilo electron volt Fe57 excited nucleus will move with a velocity 8.2 into 10 to the power 3 centimeter per second in the direction opposite to the direction of emission of gamma ray, and it is in accordance with law of conservation of momentum. This is excited nucleus of Fe57 having energy 14.4 kilo electron volt. It emits gamma radiation in this direction with frequency 3.5 into 10 to the power 18 per second, and according to the law of conservation of momentum, the daughter nucleus or recoil nucleus will move in a direction opposite to the direction of emission of gamma ray with velocity 8.2 into 10 to the power 3 centimeter per second. It is recoil velocity. Doppler shift. When a body moves with velocity v, emits radiation with frequency nu, a stationary observer will experience a radiation with modified frequency. Let us understand it again. When a body moving with velocity v emits radiation with frequency nu, a stationary observer will experience a radiation with modified frequency. That is, the frequency of the radiation will be changed, will be shifted. It is called Doppler effect. And the shift in the frequency of the radiation is called Doppler shift. The Doppler shift is denoted by delta nu. The Doppler shift is given by the following relationship. The Doppler shift is equal to frequency of the radiation into V by C. The terms involved in this equation are given below. Nu, frequency of the emitted radiation. V, velocity, relative velocity of the source with respect to the observer. C, velocity of the emitted radiation. In the case of Fe57 nucleus, the recoil velocity is equal to 8.2 into 10 to the power 3 centimeter per second, as we have already calculated it in the previous slide. Self-assessment. Now another question is before you. Try to solve this problem after pausing the video after reading. The 14.4 kilo-electron volt Fe57 excited nucleus emits gamma ray with frequency 3.5 into 10 power 18 per second. What is the Doppler shift for an outside static observer? Here is the solution of this problem. Doppler shift, that is delta nu, equals to nu into V by C. All these terms have been discussed earlier. Doppler shift equals to frequency of the radiation, 3.5 into 10 power 18 per second. V, recoil velocity, as calculated earlier, 8.2 into 10 power 3 centimeter per second. And velocity of radiation, 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter per second. On solving this equation, the Doppler shift comes to be 9.6 into 10 power 11 per second. That is approximately equal to 10 to the power 12 per second. Please note that the Doppler shift has very high value, 10 to the power 12 per second. The line width of emitted radiation, that is gamma radiation, with frequency 3.5 into 10 to the power 18 per second is equal to 10 to the power 6 per second. It will be discussed in later slide or later video. And the Doppler shift we have calculated is equal to 10 to the power 12 per second. And it is equal to 10 to the power 6 times of the line width. This is the line width. Its 10 to the power 6 time is Doppler shift. Thus, the frequency of the emitted gamma ray shifts 1 million times of the line width away from the position of the absorption frequency. Please understand it again. The frequency of the emitted gamma ray shifts 1 million times of the line width from the position of the absorption frequency. The Doppler shift is 10 to the power 6 times, that is 1 million times of the line width. It prevents the resonance absorption or resonance capture process. This is due to the fact that the energy of the gamma ray is decreased by an amount equal to recoil energy. The energy of the gamma ray is decreased by an amount of recoil energy, and the emitted gamma ray will have insufficient energy to be absorbed by similar ground state nucleus. Please let us see it again. This is due to the fact that the energy of the gamma ray is decreased by an amount of recoil energy, and the emitted gamma ray will have insufficient energy to be absorbed by similar ground state nucleus. At the same time, reabsorption of gamma ray process by the ground state nucleus would lead to the movement of newly excited nucleus in the direction of gamma ray in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum. The process of reabsorption of gamma ray by ground state nucleus would lead to the movement of newly excited nucleus in the direction of gamma ray in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum. It has been illustrated in the following figure. Gain of kinetic energy by the ground state Fe57 nucleus after absorbing gamma ray. This is ground state nucleus. It absorbs gamma ray moving in this direction. After absorbing the gamma ray, the ground state nucleus becomes excited and it starts to move in this direction in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum. As a result, the newly excited nucleus possesses excess kinetic energy after reabsorption process. It means the newly excited nucleus will have some kinetic energy after absorption of gamma ray. Thus, the emitted and the absorbed gamma radiation would differ by twice of kinetic energy or twice of recoil energy, and hence the condition for resonance absorption would not be met. The emitted and absorbed gamma radiation would differ by the twice of kinetic energy or recoil energy in the aspect of energy, and hence the condition for the resonance absorption would not be met. It has been illustrated in the following figure. This is the excited nucleus with energy 14.4 kilo electron volt. This is the ground state nucleus with energy zero. The excited nucleus emits gamma radiation in this direction, and the nucleus will move in the opposite direction. As a result, the nucleus will gain some kinetic energy, which is called recoil energy. Consequently, the energy of emitted radiation during energy emitted during de-excitation will be 14.4 kilo electron volt minus recoil energy. This energy appears in the form of energy of recoil nucleus. It is deducted from the transition energy. Now, the ground state nucleus absorbs the gamma radiation, and in accordance with the law of conservation of momentum, the newly excited nucleus will start to move in this direction. As a result, the energy required for excitation will be equal to 14.4 kilo electron volt plus kinetic energy of the newly excited nucleus. Please note that the energy emitted is 14.4 kilo electron volt minus recoil energy, and energy required for excitation is greater than it, 14.4 kilo electron volt plus kinetic energy. It must be noted that recoil energy, this one, is equal to kinetic energy. It means the emitted energy during de-excitation and the energy required for excitation will differ by twice of the kinetic energy or recoil energy. Thank you for watching the video with such a great patience. Please like, subscribe and share.